Hello, hello. Thank you so much for welcoming me in your beautiful home yet again. Yes, there's no better compliment than a returning customer. So thank you. So today, I know I'm here to help you with some kitchen projects. Correct? Wonderful. I see the window treatments and bedroom carpets worked out good. Okay, are they nice and plush? Great. So for kitchen, I would suggest maybe looking at some durable flooring. And here in the kitchen, I can tell, would you like to keep these cabinets? I think that's a good idea. They are nice and white and clean, so I think for right now it's all we need. But I would definitely update the countertops. Do you like that? Good. Well, I definitely brought a lot of different samples to show you, and we'll talk about different textures and how they differ. Okay? Let's see what else. What about the backsplash? Yeah? Okay. I have a couple to show you as well. I'm sure you're going to love some of them at least. Okay, so flooring, countertops, backsplash. How about some paint? Yeah? Well, I can show you some samples and you can make up your mind then. Yeah, we can do some accents here and there. Okay. So overall, do you have a preference for style at all? Not sure. Okay. Well, let me show you some of the things that we can choose from. Have some inspiring ideas for kitchens, and I'll show you some specific in white cabinet look, okay? And you're not looking for two-tone, right? Like this one, for example, two-tone cabinets are very in right now. So like lighter top and darker bottom. No, just all plain white. Okay, good. Yeah, it's quite popular right now, mixing in the colors, but classic style, just one shade is good. So here's a good one. I suppose it's slightly an off-white shade, more like ivory, but you can see the difference too. So this style is a little bit more traditional or transitional, I would even say. Just because of the moldings I see here and the handles, the pool handles that they've picked. And just some finishes to here. But they still kept everything updated and still looks somewhat up to date and more modern. So do you see anything that you like in here? The island? Yes, we definitely will keep your island here too. What don't you like? Dark countertops? Okay. Well, let me try to find you something with lighter shades. Okay. I do think that here will be good, like granite or quartz with some grays, silvers mixed into it, you know, yeah. Absolutely. So far I have everything with the dark here. But I'll find something here. And do you know kind of the difference between quartz and granite? Not sure. Okay. You're going for a stone look, correct? Okay. Well, I'll give you the different samples and we'll pick something. Okay. So here's a good more off-white shades here too. And you can see the countertops. These are definitely quartz. And you can just kind of see with some engravements of grays. And it looks quite clean, yet it's not just pure white, where you just have to upkeep like crazy. Here you can still do some drips and drops and can get away with it, you know. So it's more practical here. Mm-hmm. Do you like that? Mm. How about the style of the cabinets here? It does match yours too, yeah? What about the wood block? No? No wood. It definitely is much more porous. Could collect germs a little bit more, yes, indeed. So, I don't know if I have any more in actual pictures here. So I'll just show you some more styles on my tablet, okay? And also we'll talk about more of a difference in styles. Do you know which one you're leaning more towards? Like French country or traditional or transitional? Modern, contemporary? Not sure. Well, definitely, I will help you out with that. And let me see. Okay. Put my brightness a bit lower. Okay. And we'll start with the modern look. Mm-hmm. So, modern style oftentimes refers to something ultra clean, sharp, very simple color scheme. There's a lot of use of metals, glass, stone, and stainless steel. Modern style is good for no clutter or low amounts of accessories present usually. It's all about a step into a futuristic look. So it just takes you a little further. Here's another good modern style look. You see very straight lines, very clean. Good word to use is sleek, yeah? Then there's a step up even, and it's called minimalist style, just like this one, which is also modern style, but even with less accessories and less elements in it. It's only highly functioning items present. Also very simple colors, palettes. And also again the stone and everything else is present. The same types of materials are present. Okay? Then from there we go into a contemporary style. Here's one. Contemporary style and modern style usually goes hand in hand, but contemporary usually doesn't adhere to any one specific style. It's more about here and now, present comfort, yet with elements of modern in it. I do think that could be potentially an option for you, just because it allows it allows for like hand pulls, because modern would not allow you that. And you still have the beautiful style of modern with glass, stainless steel, and also stone. So that's my again personal favorite one. Here's another one, good one. Same thing, also contemporary. Still very clean, straight lines, but you can see more accessorized item. Okay. And then we can look into more specific styles, such as industrial. What do you think? Well, industrial style refers to something that is urban or like a warehouse loft look. You will oftentimes find a lot of exposed brick, suspended metal light fixtures, a lot of natural elements such as wood, metals, exposed ductwork, exposed beams. So some of these elements are just very natural, but again, it's more of an industrial look. Then we have mid-century modern. And that style takes us into nostalgic times of 1950s and 1960s, at the age of no fuss. Very chill atmosphere, again, functioning pieces that are organic in its material. So you will see a lot of wood items, but also very modern, clean, very modern, clean look, too. See some natural egg-shaped chairs. They were very popular. And here's another good example. You can see they're all very, very similar in styles, but yet it's still a modern look to it. What do you think about that one? No? Okay. Well, I like that one as an option too, so, okay. Let me see. So here's a French country look. And that's usually a very elegant style, full of accessories, full of ornate finishes, such as on this part, or you will see very, very interesting designs on crown moldings, a chandelier. It's much more luxurious. There's a mixture of textures usually and heavy linens. Potentially, it looks of a charming French country as you think about it. Slightly aged, slightly worn. A lot of displays of beautiful china or dishes. So, that's just something to consider as well. Mm-hmm. There's also transitional styles. Here's another French country for you. You can see a hood exhaust vent. Looks like old fireplace, doesn't it? Again, definitely no lack of accessories. Heavy linens on the windows. Beautiful style still. there's some transitional looks. Transitional is also one of my favorites. And that's usually something from both modern and traditional styles. So you will also use different textures, silks, linens, velvet. In traditional, you would see a lot of rich wood colorings, but since we're going with the white shade, it won't be. But you will see some of this barn style look handles. And you will still see some traditional features, such as different touched crown moldings, like French doors, opening cupboards with exposed dishes. Definitely more allowance for displaying things, knickknacks and such. Here's another one. Definitely almost a barn look, but also still with updated features. Everything's still updated, but just slightly more traditional way. So this is the transitional style for you. Well, I personally love contemporary style because it's just, it's more up to date. It goes out of style very slowly, unlike traditional styles or modern features. Those go out of style quite quickly. But French country, industrial style, I would think too, including contemporary styles, are going out of style quite slowly. So you're given much longer time to enjoy it. Yes, so contemporary it is. Okay. Also, based on that, let me give you some of the options for you then. Okay? Alright. Let me just set up for you. So here are some samples for you to take a look at. And these are four countertops, obviously. So here we have a lot of quartz options for you to look at, and a couple of granite. I know that you were not sure between quartz and granite, so I hope I will help you sort it out. So the difference between the quartz and granite is that granite is a porous material. It's a natural stone that's just cut into slabs and then transferred to your home. The positives is that it's one of a kind. Each slab will never be replicated. The bad sides, the cons, is that it is porous and you actually have to take care of it. So you have to clean it with special types of cleaners to get rid of the any bacteria and make sure that it doesn't stain it. Granite can get stained quite easily if not wiped on time. Okay? So that's just one of the downsides. Plus, because granite usually is discovered in other countries, you will be paying for shipping and delivery. And again, it's going to be from far, far away coming to your house. While quartz is a man-made stone. Well, it's actually mostly stone, but it's a pressed stone with some elements of resin included in it. So it's fabricated stone. It's quite easy to implement different pieces of glass or other stones in your choices, like this one. Take a look at this one, how beautiful this is. It's quite popular to use recycled materials to be placed into quartz, like recycled bottles. Usually it's made in your local facility somewhere, so you won't be paying for international shipping and bringing it to your house, but you won't be a unique item though. The good thing about quartz, however, is that it's quite hardy. Virtually almost nothing can break it. But it's not very good with heat because of that. So you will have to make sure to use pads before placing any type of hot surfaces on top of it. While granite can tolerate a little bit more. So all of these choices, which ones do you like? One with inclusions. Yes, I like this one too. Anything from this little row? This kind. Yes, I like this one too. It also has little tiny inclusions. They're not as prominent, but tiny shine and glisten to it too. Yes, quite nice. Which else? This one? Sure. Yes, this one has little tiny engravings in it. They look like little bagel seasonings. Like everything bagel. So it's going to be easy to conceal any, you know, little dirt that could be left on the countertops if you have kids, you know what I mean. Or husbands. How about this gray one? Too busy for you? Okay. Yeah, I agree. And as far as granite, not at this time. Yes, it's quite popular. Well, yes, as far as pricing goes, it is somewhat a similar price. Sometimes quartz could be slightly higher depending on the type of inclusions that you want to be included. Okay. So this one, that is. Yes, I think this one's my favorite too. Good choice. I love that it includes some glass pieces. So as the sun comes in and out of your house, you'll see it glisten a bit. Okay. So here are some choices for you to pick from for your flooring. So yes, I'm offering to you, I would like to insist on it too, is for you to go with laminate flooring. Well, to explain a little bit, it's basically just a much hardier quality item, costs much less than hardwood. The installation is usually a breeze. It's an interlocking system. So one lip goes into the other. This is not the same pieces, but they would usually interlock like this and make one panel. stamp it so it resembles real wood grain. I think that's quite charming and quite smart. It won't warp under my, some water drippage, so it's much more practical in that sense, and we'll know kitchen messes mean water damage. So yes, you can also use tiles, of course. Tiles are very cold on your feet, very cold. And the grout needs to be cleaned in between quite often. Your mop might get stuck on some of those, but laminate on the other side, very versatile in all of those areas. There are so many different color options for you. More flat pieces, some more raised pieces, so many colorings. So which ones do you like most? We have some of this brown, light brown, more like, I would think, a walnut kind of finish. Has a lot of engravement. I know, it looks like real wood at this point. This gray one, I think this is my favorite. Such a darling color. Then we have this dark wood white plank. Gorgeous, gorgeous look. A little too dark for you. Okay, we're going for more lighter. Wonderful. This one too has a lot of imprinting. Which one out of the top here you like? This one? It's actually a very flat surface. It looks like it has a lot of interest, but it's actually not 3D dimensional. It looks like barn wood, doesn't it? Yeah, it's a very worn look. You like this gray one too? Okay. This one has a little bit more of pattern to it, but not too much. You know, for me personally, I would prefer something that would have a little bit less wood grain, because it would get a little bit more dirt stuck in it, like this one. You'll just capture it more easily. But something like this, or like this, we'll just let it slide right off of it. Well, as far as hardiness, laminate is quite hardy. It won't scratch, no matter how long you use the legs of your chair on it. It won't get damaged. Plus, you get warranties on different floorings. So, what do you think? Which ones are a yes? Which ones a no? Dark ones a no. Okay, the brown shades. Okay. So this one goes. This one, okay. What about this one? Stay. Okay, it's close. Close, okay. This one. Close, okay. Mm-hmm. These two guys. Close as well, okay. Close, okay. Mm-hmm. So, here are your two contenders. You think you can make a decision right now? They're quite similar, yes. Well, you know what? I'll leave you both of these so you can spend some time tonight and just consider one of these. Okay? Wonderful. So I'm glad that we at least narrowed that down. Okay. So here are some samples for us to pick from for color palette. Mm-hmm. Have some of these shades of white. Mm-hmm. This upside down. Any of these scream to you, hello, take me home. Not yet, okay. Well, we'll revisit these, okay? I'll just take a look at these in a second. Let me show you some of the options that you have for color schemes. So, I'll leave you all be with all of these, of course. So here's our blues collection. Not to ever leave you in the blues. So you here see some of the lighter tones. And then slightly darker ones. Some of them look more gray than blue, but it's actually a shade of blue, okay? We can make a lot of statement with a bold colored wall, one wall or a few. You can color coordinate your cabinets if you wish to make, again, more of a statement in the future. What do you think overall these colors when you look at them? Which ones do you like? This style, but lighter. Okay, I'll definitely have more of these for you. Okay, let's look at some other ones. I have some interior colors here too. It's quite a wide variety. On top, we have lighter shades of yellows and reds. You can see some of more sandy shades here. More taupe color palette here. And again, just off-white shades on the top. And very brave. Anything here? Okay. Here's a bit more of the cooler shades. Again, we have blues. Here are shades of those in very neutral, almost pastel colors. And then slightly brighter ones on the bottom. Nonetheless, you have options for these too. Do these greens interest you at all? You are interested in more this coastal, like turquoise color, okay? Well, what about this one? That's it goes quite nice with whiter colors too. So we'll the reason why I'm suggesting grays is that I've noticed again that your kitchen is white and you are searching for countertops with gray increments in it. So we could potentially do one of the walls gray. You know, we could even do a ceiling, a darker shade too. Could make a real statement. Not at this time, that's fine. Okay. So here are some shades of that. Also, just purest whites too here. But yes, also some darker grays. Yeah, I do like this one, shark fin. It definitely has a little bit of blue haze in it. This one. This one will be good, yeah? Mm-hmm. Well, so these are just for some of your inspiration a bit. Get the grays in a bedroom. Have like a cave feeling to it. Where you can hide from the world. And just sleep in the darkness. Which is probably best for your brain. Again, we have more light shades here. Yeah, I know the lighter pastel colors are much more common to go by. I think just because it's easier to pair it with virtually anything, and people usually are quite scared of bright colors. This shouldn't be, I absolutely agree with you. Especially for kitchen, I think it could be a fun place with some spunky colorings. Yeah. So, anything catches your eye? Mm-hmm. This one? Okay. Canyon wind. Mm-hmm. We can consider. Anything here at all? These are more warmer shades, like yellows. These are more colder shades, like grays and blues. Well, it's going to be barely noticeable, honestly, on your walls. You'll be seeing the difference mostly right next to pure white shade, as it will make it stand out as a different color. Mm-hmm. Frost, do you like? Okay, me too. I like this one. So I see you going with more of colder colors, right? Colder shades. Okay. Well, yes, I'll let you be with this one. You can look at this one. Yeah? Are you ready for the other samplers? Yes, also off-whites. So here we have bleached linen, silky white, ultra pure white. That's probably the cleanest one you can find. Painter. Together you can't even notice the difference. But then once you put them next to each other, you can definitely tell the actually against the purest white color here. You like this one? Painter's white? Okay. I like this one too. I'll keep this white one also for reference. So now for those accents, well, possibly, we have these guys here. So I have these gray blues. Will look good with the painter's white, I think. This shiny luster. So here's your kitchen color, for example. Your walls here. I can do this one an accent color. Okay, something brighter, that's fine. You're looking more in this warmer shade. It's kind of a coffee, but colder coffee shades. Yeah, more like rosy. Dusty rose kind of shade. Could look good. Maybe a darker one here. No? Okay. Well, let's check this one out. The snowbound. What do you think? So these three will be your color choices. Is it a yes? Okay, good. Wonderful. Yes, the coastal beach theme I think will look great. Mm-hmm. We can add more, more accents with this coloring around the kitchen too, if you wish to tie it all together. You can put some vases and candles in this shade. Yes, absolutely. Well, I'm so glad that we figured it out. Okay, let's look at the next thing here. So let's review some of our back splashes. Mm-hmm. I know you wanted to look at some mosaic tiles, so here's one for your consideration. And this one's glass, as you can see, but it also includes a little bit of ceramic tiling here. You can see here, here, here. And it also includes a little bit of these interesting details, which are quite unique. And this is stainless steel tiles. There are just a few of them. They're just sporastically placed. So we have one, two, three, four, five. And seven total of them. I do like this specific one because I think it will fit perfectly in your kitchen, especially if your countertops are going to be matching this shading here, whether it's granite or quartz. We're most likely we'll have a little bit of grays implemented in it, and I think that this color palette would be quite interesting. So what are your thoughts on this one? Well, the simplicity of this one is very simple color palette. The interesting fact about this one is that it will not look too symmetrical, so it will bring a little bit more interest into the kitchen. As much as backsplash together with countertops seems practical, sometimes it could be a little much in the kitchen, especially when you have island and then also your side cupboards and then also the backsplash all in one stone. But of course, I'm here only to make suggestions. At the end of the day, it's all your choices. Okay? Wonderful. So, it's a possible this one, yeah? Okay. Well, let me show you another one then. So here's another option. Beautiful mosaic made out of little tiny ceramic tiles. Very simple, very easy to clean once the grout goes on it. Comes one smooth surface and you can just wipe it off effortlessly. And here I've picked this simple white shade. It's going to leave room for your countertops to be the star of the show. And you will just pull together the whole look, bring a little bit of interest. Don't forget the grout, most likely. We can do also white shade, or if you're interested, we could actually do it in a more silvery gray shade, which will mean that it could resemble a little bit of that grayness in the countertops. What do you think? Is that a good idea? Okay, so yes, as an option, I would recommend this one. Yes, a lot of people also use these as flooring. Absolutely. But of course, it looks gorgeous. Gorgeous. As a backsplash, backdrop to your kitchen counters. Okay. Alright, let's try another one then too. So here's another backsplash idea for you. And honestly, I would suggest this one as an option. In case you would like to go with a coastal theme, as this was perfectly going to match the light turquoise shades. A little bit of blue as well. It's going to tie it all together and make a statement. Also, these gray squares are going to tie together your silver appliances, so stainless steel look. And it's going to also bring it all together and have a conclusive cohesive, more united look. What do you think? Yes. It does look quite nice. It's glass. So it's going to be quite durable. Easy to wash and maintain. Well, how about a latchy bee with your choices?